Hi, Aurora. This is Grandma. And it's already 9 o'clock, so probably you already went to bed. But I wanted to read the night before Valentine's Day because it is the night before Valentine's Day. So maybe you can watch this tomorrow when you're eating breakfast, or maybe tomorrow after school, and you can tell me about your Valentine party at school. So I just wanted to read this to you because it's one of our favorite books and it's the actual night before Valentine's Day. So, the night before Valentine's Day. 'Twas the night before Valentine's Day, and all through the town, children were busy, not making a sound. Brr, it's cold outside, kind of like Colorado. They gathered their scissors, their glitter and glue, pink and red paper, and paintbrushes too. Whoa, you can't really see it, huh? There we go. They gathered their scissors, their glitter. Oh, I can read this right on the computer. Okay, I already read that part. They made cards that read, "Will you be mine?" and others that said, "My true Valentine." Oh, this is a funny one. They trimmed giant hearts with stickers and lace and added an arrow in just the right place that says, "Hugs and kisses." Then, marking the envelopes with each friend's name, they hoped that their friends were doing the same. And when they were done, they slept snug in their beds while visions of candy hearts danced in their heads. True blue, love you, say yes. Princess, kiss me, miss me, come back, ack. Do you ever eat? I wonder if you can eat candy hearts. I don't think there's dairy in them, but I don't really know everything that's in them. Time to get on the bus for school. The very next morning, it was Valentine's Day. They grabbed all their cards and went on their way. The classroom was decked out in red, pink, and white, with balloons and streamers, so festive and bright. Someone dropped by with a giant bouquet addressed to the teacher, who blushed right away. The card was signed from a secret admirer, but everyone knew it was Mr. O'Meyer. They played Pin the Heart and won goofy toys. And girls ran away from kissy face boys. Aw, the art teacher came and painted kids' faces. She put hearts on cheeks and sillier places. What do they have on their bookshelf? We love that, huh? At last, it was time to deliver the cards. Look, one for Lisa, Jim, and Bernard. They opened them up, read them, and smiled, and laughed at the cards that were totally wild. Then they ate goodies, sweet cherries and grapes, and drank punch with ice cubes and little heart shapes. And just when they thought the party was done, a knock on the door came at 1:15. They're cleaning up from their party, aren't they? I wonder who's at the door. When what to their wondering eyes should appear but the principal himself, dressed in full Cupid gear, His arrows, how golden. His bow, curved and tight. The wig that he wore was a comical sight. Did you see his socks? With little hearts. He spoke not a word and was gone in a minute, leaving a present behind. Now, what could be in it? They read Cupid's note as he leapt down the hall. Happy Valentine's Day to one and to all. Oh, a new classroom pet. I think it's maybe a hamster or a gerbil. Happy Valentine's Day to one and to all. Well, I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. And maybe after school you could call and tell me all about it. And then next week, a week from Wednesday, a week from tomorrow, I am going to be busy all day. And then when it's nighttime, I'm going to get on an airplane and come to your house. So after school, I will see you on Thursday, and we can play and stuff, and then on Saturday, and then I'll stay on Friday and Saturday, and that will be your birthday. So I can't wait to see you. I love you, and happy Valentine's Day. Talk to you later.